Just wanted to go ahead and give my review of Horizon Zero Dawn. So it's short, not really professional review, just what I thought about it, some things I liked, some things I disliked, a little background of the story without giving any spoilers. Horizon Zero Dawn is a very good game. It's a game I really enjoy. I think I put like 30 to 35 hours into the game, maybe even more. Lost track of count how long it actually was. But it's a third person RPG, action RPG. And you're playing as Aloy, the female that you're playing as, the main character. So basically with the story, she's an outcast from the tribe called Nora. And yeah, she's pretty much trying to find out the truth of what's really going on in the world. The world is pretty much machines are trying to take back Earth. The tribes have kind of come back and taken over a little bit, but the machines, not to give any spoilers, but there's someone who's controlling the machines that you're trying to find out who, the what, the how to defeat these machines and all that. You have things called cauldrons where you can go in and defeat a mini boss inside these caves or dungeons, whatever you want to call them. You go inside those, you defeat those mini bosses, and you can learn how to overwrite different types of machines in each one. Each cauldron has different type of machines to unlock, so it definitely helps if you go ahead and unlock those. Another thing is there's which I would have read up on before I finished the game was there's this armor that's it's only one way of getting it is through power cells, and I wish I would have did that. It would have been a lot easier, but I'm glad I didn't, because I did get the challenge that I wanted in the game. Played it on a hard level, defeated on a hard level. Gonna go back and try to defeat the last boss on very hard. Maybe even start a new game on very hard. We'll see. I'm still gonna continue playing it. It's one of those games that I can go back to. Anybody that knows me knows that I'm not really into going back and trying to play games after I beat them, but this is one of the games that I can really do that. Kind of like give me that Witcher 3 feeling and Dying Light feeling of going back and actually playing the game's side missions. I heard some people saying the missions were repetitive, but to me, any open RPG or any open world at all, it's really repetitive anyway. It's just about if you're having fun doing those repetitive missions, and to me, doing those missions, repetitive missions, were fun to me, which is why I enjoy it. Now, so we'll give a little background on the combat. So, weapons, and you can actually upgrade those weapons. There's different slots for whatever kind of weapon you have. So if you have like a if you have like a normal weapon, you might not have like an upgrade you can add to it. Having like super rare weapons, you can like add things to it, like plus 45% like a tear damage or a fire damage, freeze damage. There's also electric or sparks or damage. So there's also tripcasters pretty much, so you can lay down traps. So if someone's running at you, if you have like a fire tripcaster, they run and they trip the wire, and they're either get on fire, freeze, or get electrocuted, whichever one you have set up. There's also rope casting where you can actually just, as you see in the demo, you just throw a cast at a rope and pretty much rope into the ground, which is pretty cool. There's also, your bow and arrow. And like I said, it's kind of like the trip cast where you have different abilities with the bow and arrow. Like same thing I said, I'm not going to repeat that again, but yeah, you can do those. There's also a slinger that you can use, like, kind of like, like David and Goliath, like, if you see her in that, it's kind of like the same thing, so kind of using different types of weapons. That's the best way I can kind of explain that. But the diversity in machines is what I really like, diversity. Each enemy is not defeated by the same thing. They have different weaknesses, they have different strengths. So you want to try to exploit those weaknesses. Also, you can tear down parts on the machines. So you want to try to take down parts. Like some machines, they go on the ground. So if you take down some of the parts that they use to go on the ground, you can prevent them from going on the ground and killing you by tearing down some of their parts. Whereas some of the birds, I don't know what they're called off the top of my head, but you can prevent them from going back in the air and flying. Some other things, you can prevent some machines from shooting missiles or charging you or jumping in the air, that type of things, which is pretty cool. I really like that. It's one of the best things I liked about the game. Besides, and the story is another good thing. Now, some of the negatives. So, let's start off with trying to choose like corruption, like anti-corruption, or trying to switch back to getting health potions. That was the by far the worst of the game. It sucked where you're trying to antifreeze to help you from getting frozen, or antifire, and you're doing that, but then you get attacked and you're losing health. But in order to switch back, you have to keep hitting the arrow button to go all the way back to the health potion, and then you're stuck, keep getting hit and everything. Yeah, which kind of, I don't understand why they don't have a quick menu to, you get, customize your slots. I think they should add that to it. Hopefully do that for Horizon Zero Dawn 2, because I do think this will, I guarantee this will be a sequel. But let's get rid of games, and Sony Fallout, that's the only time I don't see them, not having a sequel. Like I said, if they didn't have that, I wish they would have the ability where you would go to the menu, pressing your touchpad button, go to the menu and actually select something you want to use, kind of like you're doing in Witcher 3, which gives you the option of doing either or. But I don't understand why they did this way. Maybe just not the experience, anything about that, but hopefully they listen to this, or somebody likes me or retweet this on Twitter or something, so these guys can find out some of the weaknesses that, or some of the things we didn't like about the game. think a lot of people can agree with you. As far as that, I mean, the pace of the game is good. I enjoy going all the missions. I can't think of one mission that I didn't really like. I went ahead and got all the traps together for the ending. There's different endings you can do where you can piss some of the tribes off, but I was able to get them all together. The only technical flaw was the third or fourth mission. Foot pics on my Twitter. I can't remember which mission it was, but some of the characters were missing some of their body. So I don't really understand what happened, but I went back to that area and everything was fine after that. It was like after I beat the game. Maybe it was just a simple glitch that happened, but it didn't happen anymore. I went back to it. So in conclusion, Horizon Zero Dawn is a very good game. I really enjoyed it. I hope other guys go out and play this game. Even if you're not an RPG guy, it's a lot for combat than you would think. I think you would enjoy it. But for my review, I would have to say I would give this a 9.4. Just simple fact, fun story, fun game. It's something I really enjoy, with the exception of the picking items. But it's not all I really gotta say about this. So hope you enjoy my review. Hope you agree with my score. If you don't, that's cool. So all of that makes your opinion. It's your own opinion, my opinion. But hey, thank you guys for watching. And until next time. Oh, so next game I'm playing also is Nier Automata. Between Nier Automata and Final Fantasy 15. So look out for that review. So yeah, catch you guys later. Alright, peace.
Maybe those carcasses have parts I can use.
Hey! Guess who got her weapons back? Now you're just a big dumb target. Come and get it! That canister on its belly. Looks important. Those components on the sides of its head. They've got something to do with this lift attack. Thank you. the machine controls. They might have plans. Canister on its head. Cryo arrow should set it off. Maybe those carcasses have parts I can use. Check the machine boxes. They might have plans.